My son Eric is a freaky eater.
29-year-old Eric of Cincinnati, Ohio, is addicted to French fries.
I eat basically just French fries. No one else eats more fries than me. I am the fry connoisseur.
Eric devours 1.5 pounds of French fries each and every day, the equivalent of a staggering 1,600 potatoes a year. That's 20 times more than what the average American consumes.
The perfect fry is basically crispy on the outside, soft on the inside. My mouth waters when I see my fries.
Ever since Eric was a baby, we have always struggled with getting him to eat. We would bribe him to eat. It never worked. But we did find that he would eat French fries. We took Eric to doctors and psychologists. They would say he'll grow out of it, but he never did.
Eric's fear of food took over his childhood.
When there was pizza parties when I was a kid, I was never really invited because I didn't eat pizza. I do wish I could eat pizza because then I could be a little more normal.
Eric lives with his fiance, Anne, their son, Maximus, and Anne's children, Miles and Sophia.
I have tried to get Eric to eat other things like cheese to actually take the smallest bite. But Eric has like a panic attack when he's trying to eat other foods. He has to flush it down as fast as possible. He can't even touch or smell other foods. Even having to feed the baby is hard for him.
Oh, Anne.
Are you gonna be able to feed it to him?
No.
Eric has never one time sat down and fed Maximus a jar of food.
Mealtime usually consists of Anne making the kids very good healthy food.
Do you want steak fries?
Golden ones.
Golden fries?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I just eat French fries.
Eric's diet scares me. It does put a lot of pressure on our relationship. I want him to be around to raise our kids. I'm afraid that he won't be.
I'm very active. I skateboard once a week, if not twice.
Because of his athletic lifestyle, Eric hasn't become overweight and doesn't think French fries are damaging his health.
Fries don't affect me. I don't feel bad. I feel great. Look at me. I'm fine.
But Eric's mom isn't so sure.
Even though Eric looks healthy on the outside, things could be going very wrong on the inside. He could die. His life is on the line.
Desperate for help, Eric's mom, Edna, has called in freaky eater specialists J.J. Virgin and Dr. Mike Dow to give Eric 1 week of intense therapy.
J.J. and I decided to find Eric at one of his favorite restaurants. Hi there. Eric, Dr. Mike Dow.
I'm a psychotherapist specializing in disordered eating and addictive behaviors.
Hey there.
I'm J.J. Virgin, certified nutrition specialist and certified health and fitness specialist.
Mom Edna asked us to come.
Really?
Yes.
She is concerned about your eating habits.
Just a plate of French fries, that's it.
Yes, that's all I eat.
Eric's entire diet is salt, starch, and damaged fats. He is killing himself with every bite of French fries. I see you have a laptop and a camera. What are you doing with this whole set?
What I do is I usually come in, I get an order of fries, take a picture of it, upload it to my blog, and I blog about all my fries I eat. I'm the fry guy.
You have a whole blog devoted to French fries?
Just to French fries.
Wow. So you actually have created a whole identity around French
fries. You are
fries.
The French fry guy.
Yes.
It's going to be a little difficult to take something away from him, which he's built a whole website around.
Let's hear about your family life. They do French fries too?
No, they're all very healthy eaters.
So what do they think about Dad? You just tell them that you just love French fries?
Actually, we kind of lie to them and tell them I'm allergic to other foods, so.
When you lie about something, that is one of the symptoms in the way we diagnose somebody as an addict.
I don't feel like I'm an addict at all. The reason why I don't eat food is I'm scared of it.
If someone said to you right now, Eric, your son, your fiance, and you will all die if you don't stop eating French fries, would you stop?
I don't know if I could.
We know we can help you change if you are 100% on board.
There's a few things that JJ and I would like to show you.
Okay. I feel like I cannot change.
Dr. Dow and I wanted to show Eric the enormity of his French fry habit, so we took him to a warehouse.
Hey there. We had to bring you to a warehouse because we needed that much space to show you the extent of your French fry habit.
Eric needs a dose of shock therapy to really come to terms with just how bad it's really gotten.
You're young and active, so it seems like you're healthy, right?
Yes.
Of course, I said seems. French fries, starch, salt, fat. This is the worst type of fat that you can possibly eat. It's trans fat. It's fully loaded, as we would call it.
We showed him 6 months' worth of grease, 3 gallons that he's consuming.
How does it look?
Disgusting. It looks like it should be in the dump, man.
That's right. That's what's really going in your veins.
I want you to put your hand in that.
Put my hand in there?
Yeah. I mean, you should be okay putting your hand in there. You're eating it.
It was disgusting.
So what's that like knowing that that is in your body?
Not good.
Is this changing your cravings?
Not really, to be honest with you.
Okay, well, we have some more to show you.
We wanted to show him the amount of French fries he eats in a year.
That's 1,092 orders of French fries. You're looking at 20 times what the average American eats.
The experts have brought out 540 pounds of French fries. Once deep fried, they contain around 40,000 grams of fat.
What does it feel like to you?
Lunch. I was kind of getting hungry.
I look at this big box as just one big box of death. You're looking at heart disease, diabetes.
Eric didn't really look all that shocked. So we called in 2 years worth of fries, and then 3 years worth of fries.
Every time we bring another one of these up, it's like we're just stacking the odds up against your health.
It's a lot. Who eats this many fries?
You do.
Do you know now that you have a problem?
I know I have a problem.
Do you know you're a French fry addict?
And if you had clear-cut evidence that these French fries were damaging your health, you would do what you needed to do, the change.
Of course.
So we're going to send you to get some blood tests.
Okay.
Eric needs concrete evidence that he is damaging his health with his French fry habit in order to really make that commitment to change.
Later that afternoon, the results from Eric's blood test are back. The experts take Eric to his mother's home to go over them.
Dr. Mike Dow.
Hi. I've been praying my whole life for help for Eric, and this might be what is needed.
Homocysteine is an amino acid that causes damage to the arterial lining. If it's high, that can cause a stroke or heart disease. We like to see a homocysteine of, say, 7 or below. Yours is 56. That's a crazy high number. The doctor who reviewed the labs had never seen a number that high. Now, a couple other things that you have going on. You've got an elevated LPPLA2. LPPLA2 is an inflammatory enzyme that increases your risk for heart disease.
This is an interesting one. This is LDL cholesterol. It's the worst kind. And that's what this elevated number is right here.
When you put together this combination of factors, you basically have a heart attack waiting to happen. You already have heart disease going on at 29.
It was not fun to hear that. I'm not as healthy as I think I am.
How are you feeling, Mom?
I don't want my son to die.
It's hard to hear that, you know, someone you love may already be at very high risk for heart attack. But it's not too late. So what is happening to your motivation now?
It's gonna push me to change.
Why?
You see my mom sitting here? Hurt me. I mean, I can change. I want to be able to eat other things that I don't eat.
Eric has the motivation to change, but he lacks faith in his ability to actually do this.